worship you, King of Kings. We glorify you, Lord. We worship you in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Shall we clap our hands unto the King of Kings? Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a shout. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We give him all the glory tonight. Amen.
Jesus.
I will lift up my eyes to the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, the Lord which made heaven and earth. He said he will not suffer thy foot, for thy foot to be moved. The Lord that keepeth thee, he will not slumber nor sleep. For the Lord is thy keeper, the Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand, oh.
Toate-va, toate-va. Toate-va, Jehova.
Toate-va, Jehova.
Our help cometh from the Lord. Our help cometh from the Lord. Our help coming from the Lord. I do identify with the song. This song is my song. This song is your song. Now remember that without the source, the channel is useless. Without the source, the channels are useless. Right?
Yeah.
But if you have the source, you have the power, you have the healing, you have the restoration. Because with the source in place, the vessel becomes useful. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The source of our help is the Lord.
Amen.
And because he is in the house, the vessel becomes useful. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have the source. And the source is our God. And the vessels are the tools and the instruments, the conduits he uses to bless his people. Tonight, God will bless you.
Amen.
Because he is in the house.
Amen.
Atasachi, God is in the house.
Amen.
Jesus is here.
Yes.
Tell somebody, Christ is here.
Amen.
Tell him, Christ is here.
Amen.
Now tell him, Jesus is here.
Amen.
Tell her, Jesus is here.
Amen.
Now say boldly that Jesus Christ is here.
Say, Jesus Christ is here.
Jesus Christ is here. Hey, Jesus Christ is here. He's walking in the midst of the candlesticks. And your life will be blessed. And because he is here, the vessel will become useful. Because it will flow through the vessel and be a blessing unto you. Tonight, God is going to preach. God is going to teach. God is going to speak. And your life will be blessed. And he's preaching through a vessel. A man who is a conduit, because God uses him in different ways, especially through evangelism. I have seen God use him through healing, through the prophetic, through teaching and preaching. It means that God can use him in any way to bless your life tonight. I want you to make a very strong confession before I invite him.
Let me
say something to yourself. That because he is here, I'm not going to leave you the same. Speak to yourself. I came here with an expectation, and I'm not living here without an expectation. I came here with a hope, confidence, expectation.
I'm
leaving this place with a miracle of God, with the touch of God. The touch you need is different from the touch I need. But at the end of the day, it will touch you. It will touch you. It will touch you. God will touch me. God will touch me. God will touch me. God will touch me. Jesus will touch me. The Holy Spirit will touch me. It will touch me. Masukapaya. Thank you, Lord. Have your own way in the midst of your people.
Amen.
With a standing ovation, we welcome to the podium.
Let's give it to the Lord. Let's give it to Jesus. Just give it to Jesus. As you celebrate Jesus by clapping, God is restoring your hope in the mighty name of Jesus. As you clap in the presence of the Lord,
You are clapping away every fear. In the name of Jesus, goodness is coming. Healing is coming. Prosperity is coming. The power of the Holy Ghost is at work. Give it to Jesus. Give it to Jesus. Please give me a little treble.
Amen.
Jesus is Lord.
Amen. Yes, you are.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I'm not ashamed to have a pastor like Reverend Dr. Emmanuel Ahia Clothe. Hallelujah. You know, I have respected this man even when I didn't know Jesus. So, knowing Jesus now, what
will
be my level of respect to him? Way back 76, when he speaks, I listen.
So I can say no tea
because the wisdom of God is there.
Oh,
put your hands together for the Lord. I have had so many pastors.
I say,
but I must be very, very, very clear today.
It's
a pastor with a difference. It's a pastor with a difference. A pastor with a big heart. A pastor who takes his time to effect a decision.
Now this year,
a pastor who doesn't rebuke anyhow. If you see him rebuking, then it means Nwefima. Put your hands together for the Lord. And there is something very good. You know, anytime I read the morning devotional, I ask myself a whole lot of questions. I
said,
Father, how come this devotional is just flowing like a waterfall? Without interrupting. I don't know what, how many of us are reading the morning devotional? Please, if you are not, you are missing something. I have a pastor friend in the US. And last week he called and said, Pastor, you haven't sent the previous devotional. I want that one before this one. Please send it.
I said, my dear chairman,
I have another pastor friend in Canada. I want to see this man when I come. Put your hands together for the Lord. Last week, somebody too was talking to me. And I said, I will introduce you to him.
Said,
that would be fantastic. We have a pastor in the house. We have a Jesus in the house. And we have a pastor in the house. Don't be ashamed of the fact that you have a pastor like him. This church has a future. I'm saying this church has a future. You better get on board. Am I talking to somebody? Put your hands together for the Lord once more. Amen. I salute you once again, Reverend Dr. Ahia Clothe and Mama Clothe. I salute you. Mama Loco, I salute you. Mama Fori, I salute you. All the people in the house, I salute you. Put your hands together for the Lord. Tonight, I am trusting and believing God to speak to us. And I know God is so faithful. He will give us what we want. In the name of Jesus. There is something that makes me come into your presence, my helper.
There is something that makes me come into your presence, my helper. Hallelujah. There is something that makes me come into your presence, my helper. Oh, there is something that makes me come into your presence. Finally, for the Lord. Turning your face to the wall. We are talking about overcoming threatening situations. And we must understand what threats means. According to the dictionary, threats is a statement saying you will be harmed. If you do not do what somebody wants you to do, you will be harmed.
I say, bro, for nche mo ba kona se obi be kase. Ye ose ye le se wa anya obe hawo.
Number two, something that could cause trouble to you.
They are telling me no, adie betin di oha wa bre wo.
Number three, the possibility that something bad or harmful could happen.
I paid the toss me and son, so I did just say at the bonnet be, and as I did with me, I have a better war.
That is what threats simply means.
See, I can't say I'm not a profanacy chassis.
Coffee, noni, in care, of fear, Ubana, noni, my fable.
So why, and yet, dear Messiah, and I'll be with your mayor war.
Church,
as a fool.
When you are born again, whether you like it or not, you come under threat.
Now, amen.
Amen. Bible says, since the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. If by doing good, the lives of the disciples were threatened, by healing a cripple, they were called and cautioned not to preach again in the name Jesus. Otherwise, something untoward will happen to them.
And this are the about two amono about.
Then you and I must know that we are under threat.
And then I'm in the middle of saying, "Mr. Yansi, we're not going to."
For taking a decision for heaven,
sir, we see a Yansi person come.
Except you don't want to go to heaven.
I just want person because
I am not here to frighten anybody. I am here to let the church, including myself, know the reality on the ground. That you and I need to position ourselves in a way to confront every threat in our daily Christian life. Am I talking to somebody? Church, a time has come we need to lift up prayer against every threat that threatens us. We need to confront every confrontation with passion. You don't need to run away from the threats of the enemy.
Bible says he was sad from the place of glory. Can you imagine? The vice president being sacked by the current president demoted him and called one of the ministers to be vice, thereby instructing the former vice president. Do you think the former vice president will be happy? He would have killed him if he should get the chance. Satan was sent from heaven. Bible says he was the commander in chief in the Garden of Eden, walking in the midst of flames and fire, in the midst of precious stones. What it says is what comes to pass. It instructs and it is established. But when the time comes, and he became arrogant. God says, hey, know your limit. We cannot have two masters. Either you change your ways or you go.
He
says, I won't change my ways. I will be like you. We are down. But we have decided to go there. To walk in the place of glory. We are here. And when we go there, it shall be glorious.
It's
against us. Put your hands together for the Lord. I am not here to frighten you. What you need to know, Jesus said,
yes, you can say,
behold, I give you power.
What's it share? Mama Mutumi
to tread upon scorpions and serpents.
Someone nante awawo ani
and to destroy all the works of the enemy.
Naman sell bane for ni manina.
And nothing shall by any means hurt you.
Na bibi dien obetu me ahamu.
Therefore you have authority upon him.
And then to me one also.
In the name of Jesus. At the mentioning of the name Jesus,
therefore Jesus Christ Dino,
every knee shall bow. And every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord.
Yes, Christ, you're right.
A week ago,
now
I was crawling on the ground.
As a person now, or
a week ago,
now
my wife is the one who bathes me, beats me.
Nana yere ena osiesi no.
But I said to myself, Satan, you are a liar. You can never keep me in a, what do you call that chair? Wheelchair.
Want me a man to be able to walk.
I said I won't be in wheelchair. It was a surprise to me. What happened? I saw it, but this one, yeah, I say it was a surprise. I told those I needed to tell. But I said to myself, I will not be in wheelchair. 2 days after, I took my bicycle
and
I rode. When I came back, it was a challenge. I said, I am healed by the stripes of Jesus. I lay down. The following morning, I exercised myself. I went in. It was a challenge, but I said, I am healed. As brethren were praying, and as I was praying, Jesus was up to something. Tonight, I want you to position yourself. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. Confront every confrontation. Threaten every threat in your life. Take up the word of God. Stand on the word of God. Declare the word of God. And pray the word of God. The apostle says,
and
as my father considered their threats, they took the book of Psalm, verse 2, and began to quote
word to word to God.
Now much as I say, I'm okay.
You have said this. You have said that.
What
you
can
have
we?
Said this.
What
you
can
have said that.
What can we?
And they are doing it.
Now
God,
I'm yet your kind.
Empower us.
After my word,
let signs and wonders.
Now and
set the preaching of your word.
And you are somebody.
Bible says the place shook.
Bible says the one was sorry.
And they were filled with the Holy Ghost.
Now, Uncle Sasha,
they went out.
Oh, Freddy.
And what they were told not to do.
Now, they catch us among
money and were doing much more.
I'm okay, yeah,
if you are here, put your hands together for the Lord. She will do much more. Say, I am coming out in the name of Jesus. And no weapon formed against me shall prosper. You will not fall. You will not fall. You will stand in the name of Jesus. Put your hands together for the Lord. Church, let's read the scripture. Leviticus 6, verse 13.
Moses and my tossing me and say,
Bible says, the fire must go out.
Yes, sir.
Is that right? The fire must be kept out.
No.
But what? The fire must be kept burning on the altar continuously. Your fire will not go out. About 4 years ago, Bishop was preaching. At
musical.
In line with this scripture.
Now I was
sitting there. And when he brought up this very scripture, the Holy Ghost said to me,
Emil,
if your fire is not extinguished,
sir,
you will be distinguished.
So we don't wear me.
He said it expressly. I heard him.
I saw what kind, and then they were saying this.
And I wrote it down.
No, try to.
It's in my dad.
I want to move.
If your fire is not extinguished,
so where we done
one? Your life will be distinguished.
What about two abraham when you?
If your fire doesn't go out,
so we done where me am an MPR,
and you keep it on continuously.
Now, cause we are cry.
They will fight. But they will not prevail. Yeah. Am I talking to somebody here?
Yeah.
I don't know where they will take you to. Let them take you anywhere. The good news is that wherever they will take you, God is there. Hello?
Yeah.
Am I talking to somebody?
Yeah.
Wherever they will take you, God is there. Yesterday, Reverend Loco says something.
And also for local.
He brought up a scripture.
Oh, yeah, I can say
that talks about homes. I told him the scripture that he has brought up. Has caused something in my life. I won't go into details. But I understand those horns very, very well, coming from my background.
Now,
and I know what they used the horns for when I was young. Hello. Am I talking to somebody? Church.
As I thought,
if your fire will not go out,
so we are not, I am afraid,
you will be refined. Am I talking to somebody? I am not playing games. It is no story. It is the word of God. We are in a revival time. Church, it means anything that is dying must be revived. The fire in you that is dying, tonight you must revive it. Tonight you must revive it. God says, the fire on my altar, the burning and the burnt offering
for the burnt offerings.
It
must never go out. So why should you let your fire go
out?
If you're having a car and your battery runs down,
can
you move? You will take it to the mechanic to recharge. If there is no fuel in your car, you can move. As a child of God, what moves you is your prayer. What empowers you is the word. You wake up in the morning and you don't feel fine.
Now as a home foul
and you open up your mouth.
Now be one.
Oh, Jesus. You have given a stamp to die.
Oh, the
but when you feel it,
that's what this uncle
and you curse it.
Now domino.
As I was talking to you,
several near
what happened. When I had that very pain,
what this
I curse it.
Or domino
I yawn. I don't know what would have happened if I hadn't cursed it.
As this one, no mess, I am not going to be sick.
When you curse anything of evil,
and the bonnet be as a domino,
you will see it.
Yeah.
But it will not stop you.
Now, so let me see and find.
If you have any pain in your body,
so I do any pain.
Rise up in the morning.
Sorry, Anapa.
Begin to pray.
Shandari
Alabaya Kaba. Ayeke Mozamba Libyanda. Ilebia. Are you there? You are gone.
Oh,
Masaya Kalaba Baba Yalababa. Ale Mama 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 Mama. Shandari Ale Baba. You are gone. You are gone. But that's what's up.
Oh, God.
Before you realize it is.
Wow. We never bound. So we never go.
Hello. Put your hands together for the Lord. Church, if you will pray,
say, over vampire,
we shall see results. We shall see results. We shall see results. If you and I will pray, we shall see results. We are on a battlefield.
Yes.
Christianity is not fanfare. Hello. Christianity is warfare. Becky, Christianity
is the sum
without the corresponding power.
That's a mutumino nadia
is a fanfare.
And then I go as a debia obishen in this war.
And in a fanfare, yeah, we sit down and clap and laugh.
Yeah, tonight's near shot.
Oh, you are doing well.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah, some yes.
But in a warfare,
now we're coming
to make targets.
Yes,
the actual will be out to a pandemic. Now
it's your
own. So my aim doing their own thing. Tonight, any spiritual threats behind the scenes, lift up your hand. Bible says in the book of Mark 3:27, before you rob a strong man, you must tie him up. You know where you are coming from. Bible says, whatever you will bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. What you shall lose shall be loosed.
And you're standing on us.
Say, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Any strong man.
Any strong man.
In my family.
In my family.
Assigned.
To take a seat
of distraction.
Of distraction
in the family.
In the family.
Tonight.
I pray.
Binding
the hand
of that person.
Of that person.
I don't know the person. But you know the person.
You know the person.
Who has been assigned.
Who has been assigned.
With that very task.
With that very task.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I command the fire.
I command the fire.
God.
Where is it?
To bear.
To bear.
Of him,
in the name of Jesus,
Say, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Any day.
My name is mentioned. In the covens
of the enemy.
Let the fire
of
strike in
Jesus' name.
Finally, we are praying season and stopping every spirit of stroke. When the Lord mentions something, it means He knows why He's mentioning. Say in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I take authority.
I take authority.
Spirit of stroke,
Jesus.
Let's remain silent before the Lord now. Let the Holy Ghost move in the midst of his people. I have no other God but you, Jesus.
I have no other God,
Jesus, Holy Spirit, we worship you.
Satisfaction and the release that you have. And if somebody, you have a release tonight, I want you to appreciate God by putting your hands together. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you. We bless you. In Jesus' name. Amen. We are truly indeed blessed by today's ministration. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. Reverend Matthew. Amen.
Amen.
Child of God, we want to bring our offerings unto the Lord this evening. And as such an atmosphere, you want to sow. You don't want to take something ordinary. Take something extraordinary. You want to tap into the atmosphere. There is a window in the realms of the Spirit that is open.